and gentlemen, this is something they call a groundbreaker. So let me first apologize to the shirts and the ties for your makeup. Cause I make you ugly. As soon as it drops, we're on a rampage. Bubbles popping up before you know it. There's rubble and dust, cause we'll be pushing it up. Somebody say, you ladies and gentlemen, what you're about to witness is no illusion. And now we got the bass banging from here to Buckingham Palace, they're all moving. Hey Simon, working them up, turning them psycho. Everybody rock, let's bring the house down to rubble and dust, cause we'll be pushing it up. Somebody say, you better run. Yeah, I predict an earthquake up in here.
I'm joined here with Ed Fahey, which is a great experience in National Hot Rod Driving and Banger Racing as well. And the reason we're going to have a chat with Ed here is because, of course, Ed knows a lot of the guys that's coming in on from the Hot Rods today. So, Ed, how do you think they're going to get on, these guys, John and Glenn and Adam?
It'll be a definite experience for them. It'll be good and it'll be bad, because they're used to racing where they're not allowed to hit each other and to get punishment for hitting each other. So this can be a case of, you know, the shackles are being released, they can do whatever they like.
Yeah, which would be bad.
More or less, well, within reason, of course. I mean, they know what they're letting themselves in for, which is good. Yeah. I mean, the crashes in National Hot Rod Racing have been awful harder and awful faster.
Yeah.
So they're not really designed to crash, obviously, but they do crash occasionally. So
yes.
I mean, crashing is all part of the quarter of mile oval racing. They hit that wall hard at least once in their career.
Yeah.
So either on purpose or to
different.
But I mean, they've stuff to worry about, say, like stuck throttles and all that, so they don't need to worry about that.
They seem to be fairly excited there. We were just chatting to them there. They're fairly excited. I mean, they're looking forward to today. So.
How is the rush? I mean, you know yourself, Brian, the buzz you get off getting under the nut to compete. It doesn't matter what you're racing.
Definitely.
Small class or big class. But
it's,
I think
it's great to have them on board as well. They've been very good to come on board with the whole charity thing we're doing as well. So
we're hoping
at the end of the day, we're hoping to just get out of the whole thing safe and with a smile on their face and handshakes all around it. That's what it's all about, really.
Absolutely, yeah. But yeah. I think it'll be an experience for them, but I think they might find they'll enjoy it. That's what I'm worried about.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you know, Adam Maxwell got into the Banger International Team Championship here 2 months ago, and he was, I'll see the girls, and by the end of the day, he was buzzing, and he was very impressive as well. Like, some of the hits he was pulling off, some of the followings, very impressive.
Yeah, so he's talking to him there, he's lining himself for a bit more Banger Racing during the year as well. So
yeah, well, I mean, the micro formula probably is the best one to take him to begin with, because the cars are very easy to get hold of.
Yeah.
The irony of it is the Mondeos are actually getting harder to find now.
True,
so
true, yeah.
I see
they
got, like, micros everywhere, so see they get on.
It's definitely a good way to start, isn't it, the micros?
It is. Well, the speeds are relatively low, they're easy to get. You don't need to do stuff like changing engines, changing gearboxes.
Yep.
You don't need to spend weeks welding them up.
Off the road and get it ready.
Pretty much, I mean, it's probably the closest you get to the old way of doing it. Literally, kick the windows out and off we go, you know?
Yeah, that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Well, listen, Ed, we'll leave it at that. And thank you for taking the time. And I hope you enjoy the day yourself. All right,
so
here's Kevin Moore, now the main man, who himself and Barbara have set us on this journey of the whole fundraising event for the Ronald McDonald House. And here we are today, Kevin, on our last day of fundraising. So can you tell us can you shorten this down, like, what's after being the last couple of months?
Been very busy few months, as you know, you're a part of it. We worked on, I think, about 6 micros just to get to here. Everything went brilliant. Just blown away what we've got so far. And today is the last of it. So. It's going to be a good day.
Yeah.
Good.
It's going to be a good day. And so many people have donated time and cars and prizes. Just so many people to thank, like, along the way, really.
All unreal. We try our best to get around to the event, but there is a lot of people. We will thank you all.
Yeah. And so, after today, then, I think you were saying in the next couple of days, we'll be counting up everything that's come in, and we'll be letting out the figure of what's in the rate. But we're very happy with what's
brilliant.
Yeah.
Immense. Very good.
And when we spoke at the very start, you were saying we'd aim for 2,000 to get Molly's name on a plaque on the Ronald McDonald House, and that was blown away, no problem.
Blown away.
And we won't just say on camera, but we're very happy about what's in. And we will be saying it very shortly, won't we?
Yeah, you will.
So, listen, I'd just like to personally thank yourself and Barbara for asking me to help you out along the journey. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Brian. All right. Thanks,
so
everyone else.
So
brilliant.
All right, thank you very much. All right. A lot of late nights in the garage.
Yeah. Car come together anyway. Or was this one you had along the line?
No, well, it's took a while to build, but we got there.
Yeah.
Just a lot of things went wrong. But.
Well, how is 2018 going for you so far?
Good, yeah.
Yeah?
I stayed home.
You seem to have a busy schedule ahead of yourself being world champion.
Yeah, a lot of racing. Just trying to do as much as I can this year. Just
yeah. Yeah. No, we just wanted to thank you personally for coming along today and booking in today's meeting with part of the Ronald McDonald House. It's great to see so many world champions on track along with yourself today.
Yeah, it should be a good laugh.
Something different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, listen, you're going to enjoy yourself anyway.
Try my best.
Yeah, listen, we'll talk to you later on.
All the best. Thank
you. No matter. All right,
thanks
a minute. I was joined here with Leonard Lund, 215 driver. Well, Leonard, you're having a good season so far.
It's not too bad.
Yeah.
Well,
since the World Championship over in Ipswich in 2017, you had a great run as well. We were over there that night, but say you're hoping to get qualified into that again this year, are you?
It's the plan to get back qualified, haven't
we? Yeah.
All been well.
So far, so you've a busy year ahead of you, so if you're hoping for that.
Yeah.
So you look forward to today's event?
I look forward to it, it's been a good number.
Good entry of cars in as well, and we didn't give a lot of other world champions up with you today.
That's it. There's four or five there.
I think there is, and I think there's effort for the Pro Stock World Championship under your belt as well, so it's good to have that experience under you today. So you brought the micro, the car of choice today, are you happy with it?
Happy enough. I tested it yesterday and seen it's alright.
Yeah, it didn't scare you with speed around, no.
No.
Listen, we're going to wish you the very best anyway today, and we'll talk to you later, alright?
No bother,
thank you very much.
Alright.
So we're down here with the car number 23, Mark Morrill, driver. First time in a banger.
Yep.
Well, are you looking forward to it?
Just a bit.
Just a bit. Are the nerves kicking in yet?
No, not too bad.
But you'd be well used to the front wheel drive stuff, being a former world champion yourself too, so you've that bit of experience under yourself going out there. But you find this a different ball game, built your own car and all, did you?
It's totally different, but the way you start off, the way you really bossy the word.
Yes.
But this year, don't you just
lash it up?
Just crash it.
I tell me, have you any plan up your sleeve on track today? What way are you going to approach? Are you going to go crashing, or are you hoping to get a win out there today?
I'd like to try to win the first race in the end.
See how it goes after that.
See how it goes in the next one.
one.
Yeah, that's I think the good way. That's the good way to be thinking. In fairness, but your car turned out very well. Fair play to Gary Jackson. I see you done your right hand fee as well. So he turned it out well. So listen, we're going to wish you the very best luck and be safe out there. All right, we'll talk to you again soon. Thanks a million. So we're joined with Adam Maxwell, another former world champion in the hot rod racing. So Adam, how are you feeling after your busy week building the Spanger?
Pretty stressed out, to be honest. Had a few problems there during the week, but we got to
turn the camera around now.
we'll go to that.
We had a few problems during the week, but managed to get her going there. Didn't get any sign writing on her, but she's still...
Yeah, she's going. She's ready to go. She's ready to go, that's the main thing. And how is your Banger racing going for you so far this year? You happy enough that you're...
Yeah, no, to be honest, I just sort of tried to take a wee bit of a break from the hot rods, and then I got on to Steve-O here, and he's been giving me a sort of advice and stuff on how to build the bangers. So I've sort of just been chasing the buzz this year. Yeah. I wasn't really meant to be doing a whole pile, but I've managed to do.
You're getting in deeper than you were expected.
So it's my third banger meeting in the year already, and
once you're enjoying it,
it's good now. I'm hoping to do a couple more micro meetings. I don't think I'm going to do too many unlimited meetings, because obviously the finance of doing that, if you wanted to do it, you're going to have to keep at it, because it's just for the gear, it's a lot of money. Like.
Exactly. But what do you think of John and Glenn also joining in with you today as well? Something different, isn't it?
It is, the first couple of meetings that I had a wee bit of experience, like I sort of have a bit of an idea what I'm in for, like, but I think they might get...
you won't be telling them any of your little tips so far, like...
it's bangers, isn't it? You don't know what's going to happen, anything could happen, you get took out in the first corner.
Yeah.
It's just the way the sport is, like, so...
Yeah.
But I'm enjoying it, it's good.
Good buzz. But listen, on behalf of ourselves, who's been running the whole charity event, I'd like to thank you for coming on board as well today, and fair play to you for everything you're doing with us as well, so it's great to have you, and I hope you really enjoy yourself and be safe.
Thank you very much.
So we'll chat to you again later, all right?
Thank you.
John Christie, National Hot Rod former world champion, 962, and your first time here in a banger, John. So, how are you feeling so far?
Not nervous yet. probably will once the first heat, I'm sure I'll start to get nervous, like, but no, fine so far. Just looking forward to it at the moment, actually.
Very good. You've a very well turned out car. The boys turned out a nice car, so I see you're happy enough with that.
The car's brilliant, like, I couldn't believe it. I went down, picked it up, and the boys did all the work on it and got it all ready, and all the safety stuff in it, and all sitting looking brilliant. Lee Nicol did a great job, LGN with sign writing.
Absolutely, the sign writing is fantastic. And fair play to everyone who, with the raffle you've done as well, you raised loads of money in on the charity. That's so fair play, and well done to everyone who won the prize at that.
I was brilliant. Everyone happened so quick, so raised a lot of money for that. It's like £900 or something, just that alone, and got the names on them also. No, thank you for everybody that did that.
And tell us, you have no strategy yet. What about the other horror drivers? Will you be sticking together, do you think, or will you have to be watching out for them?
I would say I'll have to watch out for them. I'll probably get a chance to actually get to probably hit each other, so we might just have to be going for it.
Take a legal shot at them. Well, listen, John, we're going to wish you the very best for today, and we'll speak to you a little bit later on, all right? So best luck to John Christie. All right, thank you very much.
Back right up. Okay.
Glenn Benn here, the winner of heat number one. Well, Glenn, how was that for you?
Good, really enjoyed it.
Good, boys. You were flying out there.
Definitely an experience, to say the least. Don't know if I'd do an hour when I get the day over my head on the side.
Ah, Jesus, yeah, you seem to be going well. You came up well up the field and everything. You were flying. The car was going well for you too. You happy enough with it?
Yeah, it was, yeah. Just getting stuck in, you know. I think if you're just driving around, you're just a target. So I just like get stuck in here.
You're dead right, you're dead right. And the track now, a bit wet now for heat two, number two, but that'll be no problem to you. Many of your experience, are you looking forward to it?
I don't know. There's a load of oil in one of them corners. I've never seen the 2-liter there. So
right.
It'll make it interesting.
That'll make it exciting. But listen, we wish you all the best for heat number two. All right, we'll talk to you. We'll be right back.